come to you because I am sent to you. I am she who was Estelle Roberts on the earth. But no longer. You don't know, my dears, how much joy it shall bring you when you also can denounce your last identity, having found a new one. Who did I could show you the glories my eyes have seen since the day of my enlightenment. I have been sent this day by one who you all know, but one that I should most enjoy to describe to you in the glory that I see her. I refer to the sweet experience of light that has been given the name Kuan Yin, the goddess of mercy. I have been before her only recently. I've seen those eyes looking at me, and they are as the eyes of one you might call extraterrestrial. They're not quite human eyes, my dears. They appear to be almost hollow in an odd way. There's a sense of a vacuum there, but in that vacuum, one is drawn into a wondrous swirl of love. But I say the vacuum exists. I've pondered it deeply. I found the vacuum to be the great love that doth not put anything there, but allows you to be who you are completely. It's as if she would take no space, but allow you to take the space you need to be who you are. Sweet indeed is her fragrance, and it's ever present. You know, you can't get close to her, but that you are filled with it. And I do not speak, ladies and gentlemen, of the fragrance as of your lovely peacocky flower. I speak of the fragrance that permeates your aura. It's a feeling that hath smelt it, and the sweetest smell you can conceive of. It's so sweet that to enter into it, mind you, I don't say breathe it, for one does not breathe it, really, but to enter into its fragrance is to be in heaven. It's that sweet, that quick. And so, whilst in her presence, you are indeed in the most sublime heaven, and are experiencing simultaneously your observant self watching it as well as dead life. She tends to project herself with very dark hair, as one would expect, in that she represents Asia. Her skin, indescribable really, it isn't quite skin, is it? It's rather a light that have condescended to tone itself down so you can actually gaze upon it. And so it is, of course, she is ever surrounded by her own glow. She would look a bit like a glowing candle near a canopy that was a bit cloudy, if you will. The light ever shining through her, as if her body itself were transparent, and thus a lovely candle shape for that which glows within. To which there's always a beautiful pink hue, and a lovely purple one as well. Kuan Yin knows, obviously, of your gathering this day, and so simply here, simply to say, that she'll guide each one, that she'll read each petition, and that this day she wants you to know she's in a very good mood. That was how she put it to me. I understood immediately she attempted to convey her, atmosphere, or the way she is, into an earthly counterpart. Each one here has got some writing to do, but no assignments are given. Each here would benefit by forgiving yet one more person that you know. But you need no means. And each here is about to experience a grand and holy opening in the heart itself. This year. And that is a place. Good comes ever. Kuan Yin would have it so. As her humble servant, I have come. Delivered now, I listen. Your favorite, my dear, is well. And each one of your auras, a lovely flower. You'll be happy to know that you all decorate Kuan Yin's flower. We love you. Always. Always. Yeah.
Dawn on me until halfway through this message that Kuan Yin has always been considered one of the lords of karma, and that this ritual of burning things, petition, being very ancient, is usually directed to the lords of karma. In this case, we're kind of just saying, I want to get rid of this thing, it's so deep. But that's really true, and I haven't made that connection until it's halfway through it. And I realized that, you know, we would draw Kuan Yin in the Kuan Yin space. And then we did. And so we're blessed with it. It's to me though, these things are beautiful little experiences that help us to remember that the gods and goddesses are not way out there somewhere. That they're really close, that they're right here, they hear us, you know, that they're addressable, you know, that they know what we're up to, and they get involved whenever they can. Thank you. Thank you very much.